great game on the menu tonight, folks, between the Oregon Ducks and the UCLA Bruins. Number 42 is one of the players that you're going to want to pay close attention to tonight.
Brad, this kid combines exceptional athleticism with exceptional basketball skill on offense. That's a scary thought for opposing defenses, my friend.
The Bruins will definitely try and capitalize on his capabilities tonight, Dick. The Bruins are facing a very formidable opponent, Dick. What are the keys to their success?
Hey, tonight the keys to their success are these, Brad. Number one, I look for the point guard to be in control of the team out there. He's got to be the leader. He's got to be the boss. He's got to be in command. Next, pound the ball inside. Challenge their big men. And lastly, keep the mental mistakes to a minimum. Turnovers could be the story of this one, baby.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. Fed the low block. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? He keeps the dribble as they reset.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
Inside. Number 10 takes the feed. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Gave it up. The point guard gets the pass. Trying to pack it inside. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Dribble, gives it up. He puts it up. He gets that one to fall. From three-point territory, way off target. Inside. Using his size with a power move.
Oh, what a power goal. Jump stop. Takes the ball with a goal. Strong.
For two, Oregon are on a bit of a run.
Let's see how long they can keep it on, Brad.
Gave it up. Number 42 with the fake.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way and you spin back the other way.
The center gets the ball. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
And the ball goes out of bounds. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Show me that one again.
Entry pass in the paint. He's going to muscle it on the inside.
What an explosive move to the goal. No wasted time. He had his mind made up. He was attacking the basket.
On the dribble, gives it up. Oh, that's good defense. A steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
In the post. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
Gave it up. Entry pass in the paint.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
A that's a foul. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I'll tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
I can't believe there wasn't a whistle on that one.
Yeah, it should have been a whistle right there. I thought there was definitely an offensive charge.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Here's a spin down to the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. Use the sky hook, the jump hook, now the spin move to the goal.
For the bucket. Doesn't go. The center with the ball. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Contact causes the shot to come off.
Line of ball, pressure, help side. It's all there.
Tries for two, and in and out. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
On the dribble, gives it up. This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job.
Up and inside.
He shoots from the elbow. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. He'll regroup the offense.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck. Where's he going?
Pull-up jumper from way out. Great shot.
That's a 9-zip run.
The center takes the pass and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Oregon are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
What kind of energy are we looking at after that timeout, Dick?
That's winning energy, baby. The team with the most energy and execution goes home with the big W.
Jumps in. Not a whole lot of luck getting the baskets to fall lately, Dick.
They definitely aren't getting the bounces right now.
Shows patience waiting for the reset. Goes up for two. They still don't score. Gave it up.
There's the trap.
Fake. Shoots it.
Another brick, baby. Building a new arena.
Here's a double team. The Ducks have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Brady's on fire.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. The lay-in.
I have a challenge for all of you. Go to every computer in your house, your mom's, your dad's, your sister, your brother's computer, and install it. Wait, Mom, before you check out.
Goes for the deep one. You betcha. he'll bring it up. And he'll kick it back outside. He shoots from downtown. He hits it. Porter
is eager and excited to compete.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
On the outside, way out on top, controlling the ball. They can't seem to get the ball to go in tonight, Dick.
They have to start making better passes and start going towards the basket more.
Playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get it.
Ante tried to make the spectacular play, but now he's embarrassed.
There's a double team waiting there.
Steal, go up the other way, get a layup.
And he goes with a spin, draws the foul, and gets the basket.
He's into it. Win, baby, that's his name. I like that in a player. Just play, son, just play. Let your game do the taunting.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. Makes the foul shot. The Bruins are frustrated. They better be careful or they could find themselves in really a nasty funk out there, Dick.
And they're doing things that a JV team wouldn't do. Emotionally, they are definitely dead.
When you're one of the top-ranked teams, you got to bring your best every night. Teams are always looking to knock you off.
Brad, when you're a top 10 team, you have to realize that teams will give their extra effort against you. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
That's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Off the rim and no good. Both teams looking to get things going here.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
From the baseline, they'll bring it out on top. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
10 seconds left on the shot clock. They work the perimeter. He's open if he wants the shot. For two. He's definitely hogging the ball like you hogged the microphone.
Hey, sure he is. I can hear snorting from here.
Turns it over. Fast break possibility coming.
Up and inside.
On the dribble, gives it up for the bucket. Drops the bucket despite the harm. On the inside.
Double team now, bad angle.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you gotta have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
You can't go those kind of stretches against a team of this quality and expect to win. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad, despite his performance, he has been unable to get his teammates all on the same page. There's a lot of confusion and lack of focus down here right by the bench. He continues to stress to them, relax, play your game. He can't do this alone, Brad.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Unloads.
They're trying to build an entire neighborhood with all those bricks, Brad.
They need some buckets, and they need them in a hurry. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player to attack the basket.
Here they come with a double team to stop it. Dick, how's he working them defensively?
I'll tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
Stop and pop.
And the bricks just keep on coming, baby.
I have to start looking for some easier baskets here, Dick. Now they work it around the perimeter. He puts up the tray.
Step out on that screener.
Gave it up. From right at the circle. A severe offensive drop for them right now, Dick.
And it doesn't seem to be turning around as of yet, Brad.
They work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. UCLA have put together somewhat of a run here.
Maintaining it is the key, though. They've got to continue to make the hustle plays at both ends of the court.
It'll be interesting to see the level of energy, Dick, when they come out of this timeout. Ball goes out of play. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Moving it around the perimeter. Looking for a good shot. Got the shot if he wants it. He lets it go. He nails the shot.
That's a 12-0 run.
Defense giving some room. We'll take the shot.
They let him get into a rhythm.
Puts it up, looking for contact. Too much contact there, and knocked him off balance a little.
High post screen.
Looking for contact.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Way off target.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
He puts it in with contact and all. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up. You get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
From way outside, he gets it to fall.
Turnover city, that will always really negate any offense. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. And the ball goes out of play. Oh, that mascot looks like a lost puppy dog, Dick.
I'll tell you, the mascot's so sad, it reflects their play.
Tries one from three-point land. Off the rim and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Gave it up. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post player.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you know, points in the paint is a stat that coaches will readily look at, comparing their team's dominance in this category with opposition's. Establishing that inside presence is an important facet of consistent success.
All right, thanks, Aaron.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about it, Brad. We've said so many times, if you have great post play, you got a chance really to win.
It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you gotta think, the shooters might be the most affected, Brad.
They work the perimeter.
Great anticipation defensively.
For two, can't get the shot to go. With a jump hook.
If they can get off some good shots and easy buckets, it might turn around this awful stretch of shooting for them, Brad.
Easier said than done, though, right now, Dick. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
Working it around the perimeter. Dickie's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball in there.
They'll work it around the arc. Entry pass in the paint. Looking for the foul. Perfectly executed.
Two-for-one opportunity.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Way off target.
Dump it inside.
Taylor in the paint. Tries for two. Shot clock is dead. Moving it around the perimeter. He bombs from outside.
Awesome job of running his guy into the screen to get off that J.
On the dribble, gives it up. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
At halftime, the Ducks are up by 24. Well, Mr. Vitale, is there a play that stands out as the EA Sports play of the half?
The senior leader made a big statement as he hit the shot to end the half.
The teams are just about ready to start the second half. Dick, let's see how this one unfolds. UCLA is practically handing the ball over to the opposing team like it's a Christmas present or something right now, Dick.
Hey, any team would gladly receive this kind of nice gesture. I bet they're not getting anything but a mouthful of criticism from their coaching staff.
Our focus player update, Dick Vitale's going into the second half. What does he need to do, you think?
I think we ought to set some screens for him, a little double screens. He's a great shooter, but he's not getting the opportunity. I think his teammates have to screen for him.
Gets a hand in the way. They get out on the break. Shoots. Off the rim and no good. The point guard receives the ball. Decided against the open post and reverses the ball. Number 14 makes a great move to draw the foul. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
At the foul line. He makes the first shot.
Oh, he drained it. Nothing but nylon, NBN.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Turnaround jumper. They still don't score. There's a bat and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Here's a flash from the post up high. Takes the pass in the paint. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Doesn't go. He takes a three. Way off target. He got the dunk and one.
He saw nothing but rim and glory on that, baby. What a dunk, Brad.
Good teams will get to the line often. But getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
In the paint. Leans in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
The Ducks are ahead by 25. He fakes the shot.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Tries for two with the board.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Puts up the tray. Off the rim and no good. Beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post player.
Goes up for two.
I love this guy, Hook. You cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use it?
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. For the bucket.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his boards. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
He's going nowhere. Ball stolen. It's going the other way. That's where it's going.
Turnover city, baby. Got to eliminate those turnovers.
Turnover. Great job knocking the ball loose, then chasing it down. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
He goes to the line. Sinks it. Two at the charity stripe. Count's getting high. Gave it up. Let's it fly. No. Picks off the lazy pass. For two, perfectly executed.
The frustration right there.
Dickie really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining possession because he gets the good angle and they also have the good entry from the wing.
The Ducks lead by 23. They work the perimeter. The small forward takes the pass.
There's the trap.
The ball goes out of bounds. The Bruins are out of rhythm and they just look frustrated out there right now.
They're gonna have to turn things around fast, Brad.
On the outside.
Very soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
They work it around the perimeter. From the top of the circle, he misses from way outside. He tries the three, way off target.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on.
There's the rejection. They'll work it around the arc. Takes the shot, off the rim and no good. The dribble, gives it up, using his size with a pop. Blocked. Nice job defensively. Here they come now on a turnover. Goes up for two. Oregon are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I'll tell you, he's trying to front right now. You got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Pulls it down. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
For two, and off the mark. Takes the pass in the paint, and the ball goes out of bounds. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us. Erin?
Brad, before the game, the coaching staff told me they worried this situation could happen. They told me it's so important for the supporting cast to get involved and not rely on one player. Right now, the coaches are trying to get everyone on the bench on the same page, guys.
Number two picks up the foul. First team foul. High post flashes. He goes for three. He hits the shot. The Ducks lead by 26. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He shoots from outside. Way off target. It sticks. He looks at the hoop. That was like a NASCAR wreck and no whistle.
Wow, no call. You like that NASCAR? Hey, where's Mr. Petty?
And momentary look from three-point land. The Ducks have a special roster, which I know you're in love with.
Well, their roster is pretty special, Brad. You know why? Because of the seniors, the leaders, the dependable ones. They're so important.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
They work the perimeter with the big shot.
Did a terrific job. Triple threat position. Faced the basket, squared the body, and knocked it down.
With the fake, and he'll kick it back outside. He shoots from left of the circle, misses the tray.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Let's it fly.
He got his jumper off by running that defender into the screen.
Gave it up with a jump hook.
They better find a way to get some easy buckets to get their confidence back, Brad.
Absolutely. They got to get it going here. On the outside. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Looking for a good shot. on the dribble, gives it up, tries for two.
They're having a rough time getting it on the drop, Brad. They should take it to the basket and get some easy hoops.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
See if they've decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now.
They work it around the perimeter. They work it around the perimeter. He blocks the shot. Turnaround jumper. He might be on his way to a career game, partner.
Well, he will, Brad, if they don't get somebody on him in a hurry.
He shoots from the top of the circle.
Shot was no good, baby. Beautiful use of the screen, though.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Gave it up. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Poor decision. He has no business taking that shot.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Boy, terrible execution on offense. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. The Ducks have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Dickie's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
That's a high post screen, close to the lane.
The point guard handles the feed. He wants a three. Comes up empty. Number two takes it away. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc looking for the open jumper for two, and he scores despite the hack.
He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Looking for a screen on top and got it. He grabs the board. It might be safe just to start that bus up. I think this one's over.
Yeah, now it's about damage control. Good time to get some of the bench players into the game to avoid injury.
The fake. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
For the bucket, and in and out. outside. Number 10 is whistled for the defensive foul. Fifth team foul. Those are the types of plays you want a lot of. These kids are on a roll. Look at them celebrating with one another.
I'd celebrate too, partner. They are playing some great basketball at the moment.
Hits that one. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
He misses his second shot. Strong rebound.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Now the high screen. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post. Nice fake.
Tries for two. Scorches the net. Defense made him keep it too long. That suit's got to be feeling pretty hot about now. Things are not going well.
Wow, look at the dejection, the disappointment, the depression, the three D's.
They'll work it around the arc. You can't be that aggressive. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
He goes to the line for the first time.
I wish I never joined Operation Sports.
Makes the first shot.
They used to be good. The good side is totally corrupt now, and the moderators are power-tripping losers.
They have totally lost control. Who even does the reviews for games now? Where did they come from?
And he got them both.
I see why some of the great posters from the past just stopped visiting or went to other sites.
I don't even believe the site isn't fed with EA like other people always have said. There are
posters. Gotta get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
I wish I never joined Operation Sports.
In and out.
They used to be good. But the site is totally corrupt now, and the moderators are power-tripping losers.
They have totally
on the dribble,
control.
Gives it up.
Who even does
and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
The ball goes
now
out of play.
I see why some of the great posters from the past just stopped visiting or went to other sites.
I don't even believe the site isn't bad with EA like other people always have said. There are posters that latch onto certain titles and refuse
great
to admit
play to take that to the basket.
Be a fanboy. Nothing wrong with liking certain games. Just don't lie about it and hide behind a curtain.
Working it around the perimeter.
Be anything on that side.
Number 14 takes the pass in the paint. Can't get the shot to drop.
The forums,
Dick, they're giving this offense absolutely no good shots. Happens,
because they're keeping their feet moving and their hands waving, Brad.
I've already been banned. And it was over something not even my fault.
He launches the bomb
polite to me
off the rim and no
text
good.
Over Xbox Live and the Buck Bomb never responded whatsoever. All the posters that used to be cool people that became moderators
just
turned into
heartbroken
robots with a
see,
twist
first,
of
Bruce Lee wants a three-quarter.
It
then he plays
really
it where he gets good close
offer.
Position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebound position, a good block out. And that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of the post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
What a shame.
I used to think some of the posters were immune. That's until some of them were banned. And then I saw Bourne was popped. That's when I knew the bleep hit the fan. And the moderators have their favorites and non-favorites. Clay told it to me up front.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
He was
doesn't
trying
go.
To play it off like a funny, but he was serious.
You, the moderator, nans are sick on big power. Makes no sense.
Operation Sports. Once a proud sight. Now,
they work it
a
around
sad
the perimeter.
Sad.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the block shot.
Are you still
number three is called for the foul. First personal foul. You talk about a great drive. How about the State Farm drive of the game?
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up, up, and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
High post flashes for the ball handler. Shoots it. Tickles a twine. Oh, big time screen set on the defender. Cross court. UCLA is on the receiving end of a blowout.
I can honestly say I would not like to be at their practice tomorrow.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.
See some of my videos, and the first video I want to upload is this one right here, so I'm going to click on it. Let me press pause. I'm going to click share. I'm going to click embed, and you'll see there's a link right here. So I'm going to cut that. And then we'll go back to here and just right click and paste it. And then I want to do another video. So I'll go back to there. Go to the video I want to look at. You can see my mouse. Got the resolution. Go ahead and share.
And now this is the PlayStation 4 Pro.
Embed. Cut that. And I want to do another video, the last one. And that's how you do it. It's pretty easy. Mine here in my kit disappeared because they've all got stolen music in them. But you can see it's pretty easy. It's harder on mobile. If you end up having any issues on mobile, I can make another video of how to upload on that.
When you have auto glass damage, trust SafeLight. And one easy appointment? We can replace your windshield and recalibrate your advanced safety system.
That's great, thanks.
Stay safe with SafeLight. Schedule now.
SafeLight Repair, SafeLight Replace.
This is Mike Lowe from Operations Sports. And this is a brand new vlog about franchise modes specifically, but going a little bit deeper, it's going to be a little bit different approach than some of the other ones you're seeing out there, where folks are, you know, focusing on their gameplay and that sort of thing. Those are everywhere and they're great, and I encourage you to check them out. There's a lot actually on the Dynasty forum on Operation Sports worth looking at, but I wanted to do something a little bit differently. One of the areas that's going to make this vblog, I guess, unique compared to the more traditional ones you see out there, is that it's going to focus on design. And what I mean by that is literal graphic design. You can see there, and I'll be putting up some screenshots here retroactively on the YouTube stream. But if you're watching this live, you're going to miss out on those at this point. But NBA 2K, their new expansion mode, it's very deep. And there's plenty of videos out there already documenting that for myself even. But what's really nice about this is it really allows for you to really get as creative as you want in that particular mode, using graphic design and that sort of thing. And so there's a lot of really cool things in this particular.